Hey Bengals fans, Marisa Contipelli checking in from London, England as the Bengals get set to square off against the Los Angeles Rams Sunday at Wembley Stadium. Trent Green, CBS analyst, will be on the call for that broadcast. And Trent, the team's having the opportunity to come over here to London playing in iconic Wembley Stadium. It's a little bit of a different experience going in front of the European fan base.
It is a much different experience. This is my Greg Gumbel and I. This will be our fourth year in a row calling a game, and all 4 years we've done it here at Wembley. And the thing that we enjoy the most, or one of the things we enjoy the most, is how much support there is for all the teams. Whereas you normally, when you're at a game, you have, it's 50-50, right? You're going to have people supporting one of the two teams. At the game on Sunday, there'll be all 32 teams represented, and it's a pretty unique. There's a great understanding of the game. I've learned through the 4 years, more and more people are learning about the NFL game and understanding about the NFL game. But just the support that they show for all the teams, it's pretty unique. It's a lot of fun.
I'm certainly looking forward to seeing that. It'll be my first trip to Wembley Stadium. Now, when you look at this Los Angeles Rams defense, you always had to be aware of Aaron Donald, but now you add in a Jalen Ramsey to the mix. What can the Bengals do to overcome those challenges they'll possess?
Well, I think the thing that Jalen brings to him, he brings an attitude. Number one, he brings this confidence. I think everybody's pretty aware of that in terms of his personality and how he likes to approach the game and his the way he plays the game. So I think that gives them a little bit of an edge from a defensive standpoint. It also frees them up some of the things they want to do up front. So you mentioned Aaron Donald and Dante Fowler and some of the other pieces they have that they like to get after the quarterback. And so I think with Jalen back there, that presents more of an opportunity for them to do some of those things. And Wade Phillips, been in a defensive coordinator, a head coach in the NFL for nearly 40 years. He likes to keep things pretty simple. So when you add a player like Jalen, that allows him to keep things simple up front because he knows the back end's a little more covered. So how much Jalen is going to actually play remains to be seen. Last week, he only played in dime situations, so he wasn't on the field a lot. I think this week, considering it's a short week and, you know, the travel over to London, I think they maybe expand that a little bit, but I still don't think he's quite ready to take all the games or all the snaps.
Well, when you look at the other side of the ball, the Bengals have had struggles at times, giving up a lot of rushing yards. You have a guy like Todd Gurley coming in. How important is it going to be for this Bengals front to really try to limit what he can do?
Well, I think that's the key. I think when you look at what the Rams, they started off 3-0 and then they went 0-3. And during that stretch and really until last week, they've had struggle with consistency in the running game. And they have three different backs that they use, Gurley obviously being the main one. But that's what they want to do. They want to try and establish the run, and then they get the play action pass. That's when they get their big pass plays, or they did a year ago. And so they've been missing that this year, and especially during that three-game stretch of losses. So I do know that's an important part for them that they want to emphasize. I think there's a particular offensive lineman that the Rams have that is of interest to Cincinnati Bengals fans. So I know they want to try and establish that and get him going as well.
Well, Trent, thank you so much for spending some time with us. We appreciate the insight. Trent will be on the call Sunday. You can catch all of the action on CBS between the Bengals and the Rams.